Aloha and welcome to the 2012 Ninth Circuit Judicial Conference. Beginning immediately, and I am not exaggerating, after the end of the last conference, the Conference Executive Committee began planning this year's program. And what we've put together, I think, as Chief Judge Kaczynski said, will well meet our conference theme, improving the administration of justice. We didn't make it fancy this year. In years past, we've had some fairly elaborate themes and some fairly elaborate titles. And back, I think, in October, we decided this year, let's keep it simple. What are we going to do? In the formal program, you're going to learn about the legal issues that arise when technology and privacy meet. You're going to explore the hows and whys of disparity in the criminal justice system. We're going to discuss ethical issues as seen through the lens of popular culture. We're going to examine antitrust and labor issues in the context of professional sports. And we're going to learn from our conversation with Circuit Justice Anthony Kennedy. Now, we had intended to have two justices at the conference this year. Unfortunately, Justice Alito's mother is gravely ill, and he is not able to be with us. So I know that he sends his regrets, and I know that you join me in sending wishes for his mother's quick return to health. As Justice Kennedy will reflect, having been a conference chair in the past, and as judge, Kaczynski has mentioned, the important thing about this conference is not necessarily what's going to happen on this stage, and not necessarily what's going to happen while you listen to the speakers. The most important thing is going to be what happens after. This is our only opportunity to meet as a group. And we meet across courts, across districts, across the bench bar divide. That is a very precious opportunity. So let's use it very, very well. Now I'd like to ask the Honorable Susan Mollway, Chief Judge of the District of Hawai'i, to come forward with her father, Eichi Oki, a veteran of the 442nd Regimental Combat Team, to lead us as we honor our flag and our country.
Well, the first thing I was going to do is ask you to rise for the presentation of colors. Could you please remain standing? And color guard, could you come forward to present the colors? The color guard is dismissed. Could I have a hand for the Boy Scouts? Could I ask you to remain standing until the conclusion of the Pledge of Allegiance? I have about a minute before we begin that, because it's my privilege to welcome all of you on behalf of the court here in Hawaii and on behalf of the bar in Hawaii to Maui. I have a second reason for personal pride at this moment. When Judge Taylor surprised me and flabbergasted my father by inviting him to come and lead us all in the Pledge of Allegiance, she commented that he brought together multiple strands of this conference. First, he's a lawyer. Second, he was born and raised here on Maui. Third, he is part of the court family, or ohana, as we say in Hawaii. That's through me, his notably unnotable daughter. And fourth, he has a federal thread that runs through his life in the form of his years in the 442nd Regimental Combat Team during World War II. So like the Tuskegee Airmen, the 442nd belatedly received a Congressional Gold Medal for courage and heroism and service in the face of racial discrimination because of my father's determination to prove his loyalty to this country. I have no fear that my loyalty will be questioned, and that is a legacy beyond measure. Also beyond measure is my pride as I ask my father to step forward and lead us all in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I'm going to just take a second to say that I'm overwhelmed and humbled by this reception, something one could never have imagined or projected when he was 18, when he made that move. It was, in a way, a childish move, but I was only 18. And to think that this is the, after all these years, you know, I have the honor to be saying a few words to you. Will you please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.